Boorarum, and welcome to this Middle-earth painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the Mighty Ent Treebeard, as well as his two brave companions, Merry and Pippin. Now, in this video, we'll start with Treebeard first, and then we'll move on to Merry and Pippin after. Now, regardless of which build you pick for Merry and Pippin, the colours and techniques in this video will be the same regardless. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Now, before we begin painting Treebeard, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for all the tones I'm going to be applying. Now, I'm going to use a lot of contrast here to do a lot of the hard work for the bark. The first colour I'm going to be using is Skeleton Horde, which I'm going to coat over the entirety of Treebeard. Now, I'm going to be using a large shade brush for this. I'm going to delve straight into the pot, just give a little tap on the side just to remove any excess. And then all I'm going to do is then start just coating Treebeard entirely with this. You'll also notice it's going to look a little bit less bone-esque and more like a little bit greeny, which is great because most trees tend to neither be grey, brown or green. It's a bit of all. So that's what we're kind of going for here. So just take your time, walk your way around. And if you do start to see stuff pooling those recesses, just use your brush to soak up any excess. There we are with the Skeleton Horde now dry. What we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the contrasts. Now what we're going to do here is start placing them at random to make it feel a little bit more natural so it's not too contrived. So we're going to start first by using Snakebite Leather, which we'll start applying in random places. Then we'll move on to Plaguebearer Flesh, followed by Militarum Green, and then some of the deeper recesses and some of the dark spots you might see on Treebeard, we'll be using Saigor Brown. But first of all, let's start with Snakebite Leather. So what I'm going to do here is I'm using my medium shade brush this time. I'm just not going to have too much on it, so I'm just going to use my palette here to remove some of the excess, get a decent point to it. And then we're ready to start applying it. Like I said, just for a more natural look, don't overly think about it, just start placing them in at random. There we are, with the Snakebite Leather now dry, we're going to start applying Plaguebearer Flesh. Though this is a little bit lighter than the previous two contrasts, what you are going to get is a little tonal shift here and there, and also as it dries, you'll get a little bit more of a greenness, almost like sap in those recesses. Again, I'm not overly thinking about where I'm placing it, just making it feel a little bit more natural. There we are, now that Plaguebearer Flesh is dry, what we're going to do now is just add a little bit of depth to some of those green areas by using Militarum Green. Again, just placing it here and there, just for some nice natural tones. There we are, with Militarum Green now applied here and there. You'll also notice I've just done a heavier coat on his beard and also the leaves scattered around here and there. This is just in case you want to get him on the tabletop as soon as. But what we're going to do next is now use Saigor Brown. I'm going to start applying that to all the little joints in his arm, so underneath the bark. There we are, with Saigor Brown now dropped into those joints and deeper recesses. What we're going to do now is move on to doing some highlighting, and for this we'll be doing some dry brushing. So we're going to start first by using Baneblade Brown, which is going to dry brush over all of Treebeard's bark. Then we're going to use Carrick Stone, which we'll just do a little bit softer on some more of the raised details. Then to finish off, we'll use Deepkin Flesh, starting with a dry brush on some areas, and then around the face we'll do some fine detail painting, so we'll be using a small layer brush for that. But first of all, let's start with Baneblade Brown. So with any kind of dry brushing, what I'm aiming to do here is load up a brush, and then I'm going to start wiping that off. I like to do circular and crisscross motions, because that helps remove a lot of that pigment that's deeper inside. But the idea is it still maintains some of the pigment on the actual bristles, so when you start rubbing it across the model, you get some nice highlights. So what I'm going to do now is just move to the side. Yep, there's still some pigment there. I'm just going to go on his arm on this side, and then all I'm going to do is start flicking back and forth. It will start to pick out those raised details, as you can see there. There we are, the first dry brush done. What we're going to do now is use Carrick Stone and then just softly pick out some of those edges again. And this is the second dry brush, but don't put as much pressure on. Now that we've lightly dry brushed with Carrick Stone, what we're going to do now is do our first bit of highlighting with Deepkin Flesh. This is going to be a dry brush, so I'm just going to slowly start picking out some of the edges here, especially around his face. Then once we've done that, I'm going to use a small layer brush and then do some highlighting. This particular dry brush, I am using a small dry brush as well. Now that the dry brush is done with Deepkin Flesh, what I'm going to do now is just do a couple of little edge highlights using Deepkin Flesh, and then I'm going to concentrate this mainly around his face, just for a little bit more control, especially where his wrinkles are around his eyes. And there we are with the highlights done on Treebeard's face. What we're going to do now is move on to picking out the moss and the leaves on his beard. So I'm going to start first by using Lauren Forest as a base coat. We're then going to coat Militarum Green over this. Then we're going to layer back up using Strachan Green and do a little highlight here and there of Elysian Green. But first of all, let's start with Lauren Forest. So what I'm going to do, it's a layer paint, so it shouldn't need any, not too much thinning down. I'm just going to add a little touch of water. I'm just going to make sure I get my brush to a nice point, and then we're ready to start picking out the moss and the leaves. So if you look at his beard, it's more like ivy, if anything. So there's lots of little bits of ivy sticking out here. So just base coat those. And then round his legs and other details on his body, there's lots of little bits of moss as well. So pick those out as well. There we are with the moss and leaves now base coat with Lauren Forest. What I'm going to now do is start applying Militarum Green. So again, just going to coat that over those green areas like so. Just going to move up to Treebeard's beard. Do the same thing there as well. Now that Militarum Green's dry, what we're going to do is use Strachan Green and start picking out some of the raised areas of those leaves. This might take a little bit of time, but it's well worth it in the end. There we are, with Strachan Green now layered, we're going to use Elysian Green to do a highlight on the leaves and also the moss. Now the leaves, I'm just going to pick little bits here and there. It's got more of a yellowiness to it, so it's quite rich, quite healthy looking, very spring-esque. When we come around to doing the moss, what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to go down to the legs. I'm just actually going to start stabbing little dots here and there. It's known as stippling, so I'm just going to do a little bit of stippling here and there to get a nice effect. It's the best way of highlighting moss, really. There we are with the moss and the leaves on his beard now done. We're going to move on to picking up the larger leaves that are scattered across Treebeard's body. Now I'm going to start first with Warboss Green. We'll just base this a couple of times over those leaves because it's quite dark. Then we'll use a bit of Militarum Green in the recesses and the finish off with an edge highlight of Elysian Green. But first of all, let's start with Warboss Green. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit on the palette, a little bit of water. Now it is a layer paint and I am treating it as a base coat, but it's the right kind of vibrancy of colour that we're after. So once I've got a nice point to my brush, I'm then ready to start base coating. And like I said, you might just want to do it a couple of times just to get some of that strength into the colour. There we are with those leaves now base coated. What we're going to do now is use Militarum Green and just start dropping them into the centre like that, just to add a bit of depth to it, just around the base of the leaves. There we are with the Militarum Green now dry. What we're going to do now is get some Elysian Green and we're just going to work our way around all those leaves like so. Just, you don't have to go too mad, just a little bit around the edges. If you really wanted to, you can always dry brush this as well. There we are with all those leaves now done. We're going to move on to the fungi and the eyes of Treebeard. So what I'm going to do first is use XV88 to base coat both these areas. Then we'll use some Gulliman Flesh just to drop into the recesses to add a bit of warmth. Then we'll be using Avalanche Sunset to pick out the eyes and also the edges of the fungi. And then we'll finish off with a little bit of Baden Black to pick out Treebeard's pupils. So first of all, let's start with XV88. So what I'm going to do here is just get a couple of dollops, as always, a little bit of water, and get a nice point to my brush. And we're ready to start picking those out. So what I'm going to do here is just start picking out those fungi like so. Now there's quite a few bits scattered across Treebeard, so just check the box art if you're not entirely sure. And obviously just get a nice point to your brush as well when you get ready to start picking out those eyes. There we are with the XV88 now base coat on those details. We're going to use some Gulliman Flesh and then just cover them over. Like so, again, adding a little bit of warmth to those tones. There we are, with Gulliman Flesh dry, we're just going to use some Avalanche Sunset to pick out the nice amber tones of his eyes, like so, and then also just pick out some edges on these little bits. I'm just going to do like little stabby motions like this to give almost like the sense of like you'd expect fungi to look like, those scattered ridges. There we are, the Avalanche Sunset now applied. We're just going to get a little bit of a Baden Black and just do a little dot on Treebeard's eyes. Take your time and hold your breath. And there we are with the eyes and fungi of Treebeard done. What we're going to do now is move on to basing him. So we're going to start first by using Sternum Mud. Then after that, we'll use some Norn Oil. Once that's dry, we're going to then dry brush using Gorthor Brown. And then following that, we'll use a dry brush of Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's start with his base. So I've got my texture tool. So what I'm going to do is start with a large scoop side of that. Get a couple of dollops placed onto Treebeard's base. So what I'm going to do is just start dolloping that like so. Get another dollop on there as well. Technical terms, dollops. And once I start moving them around like that, we're just going to move to my smaller side, just a little bit more accuracy, and start getting under those roots. Once that's all applied, all you need to do is leave this for around about an hour to fully dry. There we are, with the texture now dry, we're just going to coat it all over with Norn oil. And you'll want to leave this to dry for around about 30 minutes. There we are, with that shade now dry, what we're going to do now is start dry brushing with Gorthor Brown. The idea is just to pick up some of that texture, as you can see here. You might want to go over a couple of times, just to add a bit more depth to it. And also, don't worry about getting on some of the roots, as that'll make it look a little bit more natural and weathered. There we are, with the first dry brush now done, we're going to finish off by using a little bit of Screaming Skull. I'm just going to do this quite softly so you're almost tickling the raised areas. Just take your time, and I'll just pick out some of those areas and give it a bit more brightness and contrast. And also, once this is done, you just want to paint the rim of the base in a colour scheme that matches your force. And for this, I'll be using Steel Legion Drab. There we are, with that rim painted, Treebeard is now done. So what I'm going to do now is move on to our next models, which are the Hobbits. I'm going to start with Merry. Now, there's a lot of little details on Merry. We're going to be starting with the jacket first. For this, we'll be using Deathcore Drab as the base coat. Then we're going to shade that with Norn Oil in the deeper recesses. Then highlight back up with Lauren Forest, finishing off with a highlight of Strachan Green. First of all, let's start with the base coat. So what I'm going to do is get my medium layer brush, apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water. And then once I'm happy, I've got a good point to the brush. Then I'm going to start base coating his jacket. There we are, his jacket now base coated with Deathcore Drab. I'm just now going to coat Norn Oil over it. There we are, with the shade dry, what we're going to do now is start highlighting. For this, we're going to be using Lauren Forest first. So I'm just going to do some broad highlights, picking out all those bits of his coat. Take your time. And again, if you're making any mistakes, just tidy back up the base coat and put some more wash on it. There we are, with the first highlight done, we're now going to finish off with Strachan Green. So what I'm going to do is just do a little bit here and there where the light's going to catch, so not too much. There we are, with the jacket of Merry now done, we're going to move on to the next area, which is his waistcoat. So we're going to start with Avalon Sunset as a base coat, we're then going to coat all over that using Gulliman Flesh, and then we'll finish off by highlighting back up with Avalon Sunset. But first of all, let's start with the base coat. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette, again, a little tiny touch of water, get a good point to the brush. And then we're ready to start picking it out. There we are, with that base coat now applied, we're just going to coat all over with Gulliman Flesh. You can keep it around like the buttons and some of the creases in his waistcoat, that's even better. There we are, with the contrast paint now dry, we're just going to layer back up and highlight using Avalon Sunset. So I'm going to start with the highlight first, just working around the waistcoat like so. Pick out those buttons. And then just here, I'm just going to layer a little bit just for the raised areas. There we are, with his yellow waistcoat now done. We're going to move on to picking out the burgundy on his trousers. So we're going to start first by using Barrett-Nard Burgundy. Then we're going to coat all over using Norn Oil. Picking out the raised areas after that, using Barrett-Nard Burgundy again. And then finish off with Cacophony Purple as a final highlight. But first of all, let's get that base coat on. So again, a couple of dollops, a little bit of water. And we're ready to start painting. So just make sure you just take your time and be as neat as you can. There we are, with the base coat applied, but now I'm going to coat over with Norn Oil. And just be mindful not to overload your brush. You don't want it all dribbling down his legs. There we are, with the shade dry. What we're going to do now is use Barrett-Nard Burgundy to again layer and highlight. So in the large areas, we're just going to layer, and then when we get to edges, we're just going to do a finer highlight. With that tidy up now done, what we're going to do now is use Cacophony Purple just to pick out some of those folds and highlights. Again, take your time here, and if you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Barrett-Nard Burgundy. There we are, with those trousers now done, what we're going to do now is move on to the Elven Cloak. Now the base colour for this is going to be Mechanica Standard Grey, so I'll be using the undercoat here for that. However, if you haven't made any mistakes and got white paint on this area, just tidy back up with Mechanica Standard Grey. So the colour after this we'll be using Norn Oil, which we'll coat all over. Then we'll tidy the raised areas with Mechanica Standard Grey again. And then we'll use Dawnstone as our final highlight. But first of all, let's start with Norn Oil. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette. This is not to thin down anything. This is just so I don't massively overload the brush. So what I'm going to do is just get a good point there, as he's quite a small little figure. And then what I'm going to do is just start coating that over his cloak. There we are with the Nuln Oil now dry. What we're going to do now is use Mechanica Standard Grey and start picking out those raised areas. So it's like the big folds of the cloth, like so. Start picking those out, ready for our highlights after. There we are with the raised areas on the cloak now layered. What we're going to now do is use Dawnstone and start edge highlighting. So we're just going to do a little fine line here and there on some of the folds of the cloak. Don't have to go too mad, just pick out the ones that are really obvious. There we are, that highlighting done, his cloak is now finished. So what we'll now do is move on to the skin of Merry. Now for this, we're going to start off by using Kislev flesh, then we're going to coat all over with Gulliman flesh. Once that's dry, we're going to just tidy back up on the raised areas with Kislev flesh again, then finish off with Screaming Skull, just on the extremities, such as the nose and toes. But first of all, let's start with Kislev flesh. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops, or one there, and just a little bit of water. As always key, get your brush to a nice point. And then all I'm going to do is start base coating all those skin details. Now this is over Mechanica Standard Grey, so you might want to do a couple of thin coats of this. There we are, with the skin now base coated in Kislev flesh, what we're now going to do is coat all over that skin using Gulliman flesh. And just be mindful when it starts to pool at the bottom. Just use your brush to soak up any excess if it does that. There we are, the contrast paint now dry, we're just going to use Kislev flesh to tidy up the raised areas. There we are, with Kislev flesh now tidied up, what we're now going to do is just use a little bit of Screaming Skull for those extremities. So I'm just going to pick out things like the nose, the toes, and I'm also going to do his knuckles as well. There we are, that skin now finished. What we're going to do now is do Merry's hair. Now we're going to start first by using XV88. Once that's all applied, we're then going to coat that over with Gulliman flesh. And then just on some of the raised curls of his hair, we'll use XV88 again. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette as always. Touch of water. And then key here, certainly getting a good point. And just start coating over those hair areas. Again, if you get any onto the actual skin, just tidy back up with Kislev flesh and any Gulliman flesh where needed. There we are, that base coat dry. We're now going to coat over with Gulliman flesh. There we are, the contrast now dry. What we're going to now do is just pick out some of the curls on Merry's hair using XV88 again. Just as a little highlight here and there. You can dry brush this if you want to, but I'm just picking out a few here and there. Not going too mad. There we are, with Merry's hair now done. What we're going to do now is move on to picking out some other details on the model. I'm going to start first by picking out the stone or rocket that he's holding. For this, we'll be using Dawnstone, followed with Nuln Oil. Then after that, we'll be picking out the Leaf of Lothlorien with Warboss Green, followed with Elysian Green. But first of all, let's start with Dawnstone. So I'm going to be layering this, so I'm just going to add a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water, just to make it a little bit lighter than his cloak. All I'm going to do is just coat that all over like so. There we are, with that stone now layered with Dawnstone, what we're going to do now is just coat over with Nuln Oil. There we are, with that shade dry, the stone is finished. What we're going to now do is move on to the Leaf of Lothlorien, and for this we'll be using Warboss Green as a base coat. There we are, with Warboss Green now base coated, we're just going to finish off just by picking around the edges with a little bit of Elysian Green. There we are, with the stone and leaf on Merry now done. We're going to finish him off by picking out his eyes. Now we're going to start first by using a Bad and Black. Then after that, we'll pick out the whites of the eyes using White Scar. Then we're going to paint the pupil using a Bad and Black again. Now, if you're not feeling confident to do that, just use a bit of a Bad and Black and just pick out the slits in his eyes instead. But first of all, let's start with a Bad and Black. So I'm just going to get a little bit. I'm going to make this a little bit wetter. So I'm going to add a couple of paintbrushes of water just so it doesn't dry my brush too quickly. And really key here, super sharp point if you can. And we're ready to start picking out that eye. So I'm just going to start on his right one first. It's always key to hold your breath when you do this as well. There we are, with the blacks of the eyes now picked out. What we're now going to do is move on to the white. So key here is make sure you've got a nice point and hold your breath when doing this. There we are, with the white picked out. We're now going to finish off by just doing a dot in the center of his eye. Again, hold your breath, take your time. There we are. With the eyes done, Merry is finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to picking out some details on Pippin. We're going to start first with his blue jacket. Now for this, we'll be using Stegadon Scale Green to start off with. We're then going to shade all over using Norn Oil, do some highlights with Thunderhawk Blue, and then finish off with a little bit of Dawnstone. But first of all, let's start with that Stegadon Scale Green. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops to my palette, a little bit of water, and then get a good point to my brush, and then we're ready. What I'm going to do is just start picking that out. You should only need to do one coat because that nice grey undercoat obviously will give you some nice coverage. There we are. With the coat now base coated with Stegadon Scale Green, we're just going to coat all over using Norn Oil. With the shade dry, what I'm going to do now is use Thunderhawk Blue to start picking the edges out. There we are, with that first highlight done, we're now just going to finish off the jacket with a couple of little dots here and there of Dawnstone, just so it looks a little bit more frayed on the edges. There we are, with the jacket now done, what we're going to do now is move on to picking out his shirt and scarf. We're going to start first with the base coats. We'll be using Corax White for the shirt and Dawnstone for the scarf. So first of all, let's start with that Corax White. So what I'm going to do is just get a couple of dollops, a little bit of water. Should I get a little bit more than that? It's better. Just load up my brush, get a nice point to it, and then we're ready to start picking out that shirt. So just take your time, you might want to do a second coat, especially if you can see some of the Mechanica Standard Grey showing through. There we are, with the shirt now picked out with Corax White, we're just going to get the little scarf and pick that out with Dawnstone. There we are, with the shirt and scarf now base coated. What we're going to now do is move on to applying the rest of the colours. Now we're going to start first by using a contrast, and this will be Skeleton Horde, which we're going to thin down with a little bit of contrast medium. Then after that, we're going to tidy back up those areas. I'll be using Corax White for the shirt, and I'll be using Dawnstone as a highlight for the scarf. But first of all, let's start with that contrast medium and Skeleton Horde mix. So what I'm going to do here is get a couple of dollops of contrast medium. I'll go for three. There we go, and give it a quick wash. And then once that's nice and dry, I'm just going to get a paintbrush's worth of Skeleton Horde. So it's not too neat, it's a little bit more thinned down. Once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to load my brush up. And I'm going to apply that over the shirt. Now Pippin's shirt isn't like pure white, it's like an off-white, sort of like a creamy kind of tone. So that's why I'm using that. And also it's quite an old scarf as well. I'm just going to apply it all over and add a little bit more to where his buttons will be, like so. There we are, with the Skeleton Horde now dry, all I'm going to do now on the shirt is just re-layer up some of those areas with Corax White. There we are, with the shirt highlighted, what we're going to now do is just highlight the scarf using Dawnstone. Again, just on the edges, a few little bits here and there. There we are, with the shirt and scarf now done. What we're now going to do is move on to picking out Pippin's trousers. We're going to start first with dried bark, then we're going to coat Norn Oil all over. Then we're going to layer back up using dried bark again, and then finish off with a highlight of Gorthor Brown. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So what I'm going to do is get some dried bark, bit of water, and then we're ready to start base coating. So just take your time and try and be as neat as you can. There we are, with his trousers now base coated, what we're going to do now is just apply Norn Oil all over. Just be mindful it doesn't overload it too much and pool at the bottom. Just use your brush to soak up any excess if it does that. There we are, with the shade dry, all I'm going to now do is use dried bark to pick out some of those raised areas. Just for a bit more definition. With that tidy up now done, we're going to finish off his trousers by using a little bit of Gorthor Brown. Again, just for edge highlights here and there. With those trousers finished, we're going to do the last detail on Pippin, which is his hair. Now for this, we'll be using dry bark again as a base coat, coating that in Norn Oil, but finishing off with some highlights of XV88. But first of all, let's get that base coat down. So just, again, a little bit more base paint, a little bit of water. A little bit more water. That's much better. And we're just going to start coating his hair. There we are, with that hair now base coated, I'm just going to coat it all in Norn Oil. There we are, with the shade dry, all we're going to do now is start layering some of those curls with a little bit of XV88. There we are, with the hair now done, all that's left to do is paint the skin, the cloak and the stone. For details on how to do that, just follow how we did that on Merry. And then all that's left to do after that is to paint the base. And for both Merry and Pippin, again, just follow how we did that with Treebeard. And there we are, with Treebeard and the Hobbits now painted and based, they're ready to head out of Fangorn Forest and bring ruin to Saruman's nefarious plans. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlighting, just take your time and try and get a nice point to your brush. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result as well. And also when using any shades and contrasts, try not to overload the brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed painting your own Treebeard and Hobbits, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.